Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening to all Denarians on the go and in the know. Like, subscribe, and share to help support the channel. First article of interest for today: amending the construction law and merging the investment agencies. Experts and specialists in economic affairs see that the ministerial curriculum of Prime Minister Mustafa Akazemi focused on the important economic aspects, which are investment, industry, and banks, calling for taking preemptive measures before starting the implementation of the government program, such as amending the law of the reconstruction and merging the national investment bodies and working to limit the arms of the state to create an investment environment safe and stable. Economist Majid Al-Suri said in a statement to Al Sabah, the ministerial curriculum of the government of the current Prime Minister, Mustafa Akazemi, can be described as good, and accordingly a real political will is required to implement it. The main economic sectors. He added that the ministerial curriculum of the current government has put part of the solutions to get rid of the great crisis facing Iraq politically, economically, and socially, stressing the need to start implementing the government program because it is promising and will serve the basic economic sectors, which are investment, industry, and agriculture, and banks. He pointed out that the formation of a higher council for reconstruction and investment is a necessary need, because it will carry out the task of advancing the investment and economy in the country, stressing that this council needs to amend the law of the Council of Reconstruction that is currently in the House of Representatives, as it has significant deficiencies and could affect in the work of the Reconstruction Council when legislating it in its current form. Integration of investment bodies. He also added, investment bodies should be merged in all governorates, because they are considered excessive routine circles that hinder the investment process in the country, calling for the recruitment of appropriate personalities and managing economic files to advance the reality of the national economy. For his part, economist Hammam Al-Shamaa said, the implementation of the government program by Prime Minister Mustafa Akazemi requires taking preemptive precautions such as confining arms to the state and abolishing manifestations of armament and threats to create a safe environment that attracts investors. Al-Shamaa said in a statement to Al Sabah, the capital is cowardly, and therefore needs an environment that secures and protects its money, noting that, recently, banks cannot implement the guarantees that they give to borrowers. Safe investment environment. He explained that the economy needs to develop investment, which requires creating an ideal investment environment without any interference or intersections, and that banks require their work to be a safe environment, and when they obtain guarantees on a loan, these guarantees must be implemented, not become ink on paper. Indicating that the reason why banks are now funds is that they cannot grant loans for fear of not repaying the loan because the guarantees that are provided are often financial and when due, they cannot seize the money and real estate. The start of the government program, he continued, the economy needs real and effective guarantees for investment, the economy, for businessmen and money, and this comes through taking proactive measures before starting implementing the government program. He called on the Prime Minister to achieve security, stability, and reassurance for investors before he begins any step on the economic side to implement his program. It is noteworthy that the House of Representatives voted to give confidence to the government of Prime Minister Mustafa Akazemi, and also voted on the ministerial platform of the new government. The ministerial curriculum included several paragraphs, including those related to the economic side, as it focused on supporting the investment process through forming a higher council for reconstruction and investment, and supporting the industrial sector by raising the slogan, Made in Iraq, as well as supporting a bank sector. Next article of interest. Rafidane banknotes violations and the instructions for paying salaries to employees. Rafidane Bank announced on Saturday that there are departments that have a MasterCard and pay their salaries manually, and this is in violation of the conditions and instructions. The media office of the bank called in the statement of these departments to receive their salaries electronically monthly and by means of a MasterCard, indicating that the instructions and conditions of the concerned authorities confirm that the salaries are paid electronically and not manually. It is noteworthy that the RAFA Danebank has announced, since the outbreak of the coronavirus, the approval of the distribution of salaries to employees and workers in the public sector electronically. Next article of interest. Expectations of the Iraqi economy shrinking and the budget deficit exceeding 29%. On Saturday, the World Bank expected the Iraqi economy to shrink and the budget deficit to rise to 29%. According to the report, it is expected that the country's GDP growth rate will shrink during the year 2020 by 9.7%, registering a decrease from a positive growth rate achieved in the year 2019 by 4.4%, which makes it the country's worst annual economic performance since 2003. The report pointed out that, with the previous conditions of Iraq in entering this current crisis, it limited its ability to address the economic and social impact and mitigate it resulting from the drop in oil prices, and reduce the share of production in turmoil caused by the embargo measures related to the HIV epidemic. His report stated that the economy of the public sector of the country that relies entirely on oil hindered the creation of job opportunities in the private sector. Moreover, the growing resentment towards the lack of services and the increase in corruption and lack of job opportunities are all still present, in addition to the political stalemate over forming a new government. Financial regulation and diversification of the economy through a broader contribution to the private sector are vital to reducing Iraq's vulnerability to external shocks, said Sarju Kumar Juha, regional director of the World Bank for the Mashrek region. He adds, the presence of targeted reform and a program to promote growth would help maintain the reconstruction efforts and preserve the positive developments achieved in the electricity and agricultural sectors over the past year, noting that such a program is also essential to create many of the necessary job opportunities for young people, and it also helps restore the confidence of Iraqi citizens. The report indicated that if oil prices stabilize below $30 a barrel, and no reform measures are taken, the budget deficit will exceed 29% of GDP for 2020, and that the total financing needs will reach $67 billion, more than 39% of GDP total. The World Bank stated that, according to this situation, the financing options will be limited, and the heavy reliance on local financing can affect the liquidity available for private sector credit, and weaken the budget of the Central Bank of Iraq, thereby creating pressures on financial inflation and the rate of selling the currency, guessed. At the same time, the possibility of access to global markets may prove difficult, taking into account the conditions of the global market and the weakness of the Iraqi economy system. The report included, highlighting the importance of digital transformation for Iraq and the urgent need behind it, noting that the benefits from the active digital economy are very huge, and upgrading the digital economy will help Iraq improve economic opportunities, especially for young people, and thus meet the demands of citizens. He pointed out that the digital transformation of the Iraqi economy will require economic reforms and long-term development priorities, as well as a digital economic framework with several axes that include providing access to a high-speed internet, providing digital management services, improving access to information, and developing the skills of young people and technology science. Like, subscribe and share to help support the channel. Check out the Denarian blog, Facebook and Twitter as I post important daily updates on these platforms throughout the day as well. The links to these and other invaluable sites are in the description box below. Knowledge is power. Using that knowledge is powerful. Over and out for now, the Denarian.